Well, I believe Church of Almighty God is a test case, because some groups are protected by their own popularity. They are a very popular group. What they say is shared by many. But the Church of Almighty God has a very distinctive message that for other Christians may be very new and may be rejected as heretic or even scandalous. And many attitudes of society in general are also criticized by Church of Almighty God. So it's normal that among many people, Church of Almighty God is not popular. But religious liberty standards are not established to protect the popular groups. These groups are already protected by their own popularity. So the international conventions on religious liberty are set to protect small groups and popular groups. That's the real test. So I believe in Hong Kong, how they treat the Church of Almighty God is a test. Because if they follow the CCP's idea that the Church of Almighty God should be banned or deregistered or persecuted even in Hong Kong, based on the fact that the Church of Almighty God is perceived by the Chinese government as criticizing the Chinese government in a strong way, which largely true, of course, and based on the fact that the Church of Almighty God has allegedly committed a number of crimes, this is not true. If because of these two reasons, criticizing CCP, which is true but should be allowed, and committing crimes, which is not true or at least not proved, the Church of Almighty God is banned in Hong Kong, it will be a big failure of this test of religious liberty. That is, how are we able to protect unpopular minorities? So the Church of Almighty God is becoming a test for the future of religious freedom in Hong Kong. Here I see two different processes at work. One is a question of power, and the other is a question of image. Question of power. CCP, for many years, has tried to tighten its control on Hong Kong. And so the campaign against the Church of Almighty God may be just one step in a process which will lead to control and repress not only the Church of Almighty God or other groups defined as CAGO, but also dissident bloggers, journalists, civil society organizations, and so on. But that's a mere question of power. On one hand, we have the CCP who wants to increase its control of Hong Kong. On the other hand, we have civil society that tries to resist. Only the civil society should not be misled by the fake news about the Church of Almighty God and should understand that if the CCP is allowed to expand its control in Hong Kong, in the case of the Church of Almighty God, many other cases will follow. So that's the power question. Then there is the image question, that while it is doing this, CCP cares about projecting a decent image in the West. They don't like the bad image they have. They try to correct this image. And so to justify this, which is largely a question of pure power, they try to legitimize what they are doing in Hong Kong again by an aggressive public relation campaign where they try to accuse the Church of Almighty God to be a criminal group. But the hope is the Hong Kong public opinion will be able to see through what is going on where the question of image is the mask or the smokescreen for a question of power.